Los Angeles is the great challenge of our century. When I first saw downtown, I was both very attracted to it and by the same token repulsed by it, because it was such a pretty place architecturally, and yet there was no life in this city, particularly after 5 o'clock in the afternoon. I started with the San Fernando building on the corner of 4th and Main, and then bought the Farmers and Merchants Bank building, the Hellman building, and the Continental building. They were all vacant office buildings, and we bought them for almost nothing because this was really considered Skid Row at the time. St. Fabiana's is sort of, it's a great Los Angeles story, and it really is part of our great story, and that is that it was a building that was slated for demolition and was really 10 minutes from being torn down. And now it's a great center for performing arts, but it's also a really important part of Los Angeles history that was this close to being lost. One of the things I'm learning now is not to be trapped in a real estate frame of mind. I mean, I live here, so I'm not interested in creating an environment that others may or may not like. I'm interested in creating an environment that I like and that I really love. When I came to LA in 92, I had a net worth of about $100, and that's reality. That all of this was done kind of on a wing and a prayer, and finding good partnerships and people to work with. You can't be the smartest guy in your office. If you are, you shouldn't be the boss. So I really rely heavily on staff to add the spice and the ingredients that really make these projects fly. You know, the best advice I can give architecture students is the same advice you can give to anyone who's in a creative field, and that is you're going to need a couple of things. First and foremost, it's curiosity. That and the ability to understand that some failure is inevitable, that that's just going to happen. I just find the word cynic to be a nasty word. I don't mind skepticism, because there's the possibility of redemption or enlightenment, but cynicism is a dead end. My favorite word is Trish. That's my wife. It's absolutely true.
One of the things that Tom said to me, which has always stuck with me, is that he described himself as the bones and us as the connective tissue. And I think that's really smart, because he made the physical infrastructure possible, and we came in and we provided the culture.
I try to have an impact on all of the sort of creative people that are doing work here in downtown, but also to be involved in a lot of the social service organizations. I can't imagine life without philanthropy. I think philanthropy is just simple human kindness with an economic component. And in the case of the buildings, I had some empty spaces, and I could either let those sit fallow and just advertise them for lease, or I could work with artists to create environments that help them and also help them live in the neighborhoods.
Tom is an anchor point in the community from the standpoint of the artist, because he has open access to space, exposure, and in general facilitated the work of the artist in the neighborhood.
I'm not just helping the artist, I'm helping the artists help the neighborhood. So I've said it before, the reality is I'm a lazy man trapped in a busy man's body, that I'm not a driven man, I happen to be driven. You know, it's a different thing. I'm Tom Gilmore, and it's an honor to have been chosen by Woodbury University as the Citizen of the Year.
On behalf of the entire Woodbury University community, we want to congratulate Tom Gilmore.
Hey, Tom. On behalf of the family at Gilmore Associates and, of course, the Old Bank District, we just want to let you know that we're proud of you. Congratulations, Citizen of the Year.
Congratulations, Tom.
Congratulations, Tom, from Miguel Osuna's Art Studio.
From Pharmaca, we say congratulations and also especially thank you.
Congratulations, Tom, from 626 Reserve.
Tom, you don't know how much we all feel indebted to you for the great work you've done to help us here at Woodbury and also for the work you've done in downtown Los Angeles. Congratulations for receiving this award. You deserve it 1,000 times over. Our very best to you.